Satan will. Alright? Yeah, Satan will. Yeah, we committed adultery. So please never blank out your mind. Okay? Never blank. So a blanked mind is an open doorway for the entrance of demons. Alright? So often the Lord remains silent because he wants to stimulate us to seek him more diligently. Amen? So the Psalms are a good example of this. Over and over again, David cries out to the Lord in desperation, but has to wait for an answer. So he eloquently describes this situation in the following Psalms, Psalm 28, verse 1. So many times he holds back from answering us, because he wants us to seek him more honestly. Alright? So, another thing is that if you are in an intensely emotional situation and seem to be unable to hear the Lord. Okay, so the Lord is interested in the smallest details of our lives and everything we do. Do you agree with that?
Amen.
Yeah, he's interested, smallest detail. Isn't it wonderful? Isn't it? He never gets bored with what we are doing. He never thinks that what we are doing is too insignificant for his attention. All of nature and creation teaches us of our Lord's great interest in detail. He's not like most human beings who get tired and become impatient with a multitude of detail. As you go about your daily outside working or housework, sometimes we get bored doing that. But he's never bored with that, right? He's never bored with it. No matter how unimportant our tasks may seem, they can be done in such a manner as to bring glory to our King. Amen? So, no other human being is interested in the details of your life. Each person is most interested in the details of his or her own life. Certainly not yours, right? Okay, you got it? Yeah. Everybody, they are not interested about yourself, okay? But the Lord is, okay? Satan is not interested in our lives in the same way, right? What's his interest? He's interested only in bringing destruction and hurt all our functions, physically, mentally, spiritually, Yeah, everything. He wanna, perish. He wanna, kill us, kill our souls. So everybody has a dog life, okay? So you are in a constant, thinking during every, waking moment, okay? So, are you get bored? Okay, so let me see. So as you are talking to the Lord throughout the day, the thoughts that come into your mind, building up your relationship with the Lord, okay? So leading you to a deeper love for Him and a deeper commitment to Him. Placing within you a great desire to read His word and do His will. Those thoughts do not come from you, right? Your flesh will not give you such thoughts, and neither will demons. As the Lord speaks to you in the smallest things, you are drawn closer and closer to Him. Jesus said, If you love me, keep my commandments. Book of John 14. And again he said, when the Holy Spirit comes, he will take what is mine and show it unto you. Amen? So, Book of John 16:2. So neither Satan's kingdom nor your natural self will do either of these things. This is an assurance that these sources of communication are indeed from the Lord, because you know, they make us fall more and more in love with Him. Okay? Amen? Yeah, more and more in love with Him. So please, you know, let us, you know, seek the Lord with all of our heart. All right? Yes. Because He's our, you know, rock. Yeah. You know, but if we do not, you know Him and are not able to, you know, hear His voice, you know, to receive His guidance, so we'll, you know, never be able to stand in the, you know, midst of the terrible evil of this world. Amen? So Psalms 63, O God, you are my God, earnestly I seek you. My soul, you know, thirsts for you. My body longs for you in a dry and weary land where there is no water. So I have seen you in the sanctuary and beheld your power and your glory. It's because your love is better than life. My lips will glorify you. So I'll praise you as long as I live. And in your name, I will lift up my hands. So we need the, you know, intense hunger and holy ache, you know, which causes us to, you know, press into his, you know, King David's confession. All right? So our daily cries must be like King David's cry, like, where is the glory and power in your, you know, sanctuary? Amen? Where? So, you know, then the Lord will release, you know, yeah, he will release. He will release, you know, powerful, you know, anointing in our lives, you know, through our hunger. Amen? So, I want, you know, stand in awe of, you know, God's goodness in every day. I want our lives to, you know, use as a toner, you know, for the, you know, testifying, you know, Lord's, you know, desire to take ordinary people and do extraordinary things through them. So then, you know, he alone, he receives, you know, glory and honor. Amen. So Jeremiah 33, you know, verse 3 says, call to me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things which you do.